Well, let's start with another big political controversy that everyone is speaking of from the Congress's side and in the Saffron camp as well. This after the Congress fielded the firebrand leader Kanhaiya Kumar against BJP MP Manoj Tiwari, Northeast Delhi. The 37-year-old former student leader of JNU, Kanhaiya Kumar, is currently in charge of Congress students' body, the NSUI, the National Students Union of India. Kanhaiya Kumar will go up against popular Purvanchali celebrity, also two-time MP Manoj Tiwari. But this ticket has sparked a political storm. The BJP reminded the Congress of how Kanhaiya Kumar allegedly raised tukde tukde slogans and also stated that the Congress, by giving Kanhaiya a ticket, has exposed its party's anti-India mindset.
कांग्रेस ने अपनी मानसिकता का परिचय दिया है, लेकिन जब धरातल पे आते हैं तो आज कांग्रेस का भी कार्यकर्ता पूछ रहा होगा कि इतनी बड़ी पार्टी में एक कोई ऐसा व्यक्ति नहीं मिला जो देश का सम्मान करता हो, जो सेना का सम्मान करता हो। आप उसको चुनते हैं जो टुकड़े टुकड़े गैंग का नेतृत्व करता हो, जो सेना को गाली देता हो, तो कोई बात नहीं। देखिए, प्रधानमंत्री जी को गाली देने का फैशन चल गया है कांग्रेस में और इंडिया अलायंस में। प्रधानमंत्री जी की माता जी को गाली, मैं समझता हूं कांग्रेस की ये जो मनोदशा है ना, जनता देश की इनको जवाब।
कांग्रेस के पास उम्मीदवार की कमी है, चेहरे की कमी है, तो जितने रिजेक्टेड हैं उन सबको लेके झुंझुना बजा रहा है और जिसको जहां लड़ाना चाहे लड़ाए। दुनिया की कोई ताकत नहीं कि कोई मनोज तिवारी को हराए।
The Congress candidate from Northeast Delhi, Kanhaiya Kumar, though has slammed the BJP for making these kind of allegations. In fact, has spoken of several instances wherein certain Congress leaders fielded by the Congress party lost in their respective constituencies in 2019 and this time around have been given a warm welcome by the Bharatiya Janata Party after quitting the Congress, raising those allegations against the BJP. Listen in.
गिरिराज सिंह कह रहे कि जिन्हें रिजेक्ट कर दिया उन्हें कांग्रेस में उतारा। अभी
ये बात तो उनके ऊपर भी लागू होता है। बहुत सारे ऐसे लोग हैं जो कांग्रेस पार्टी में चुनाव हार गए थे और अभी जो है पलक पांवरे बिछा करके, जो है रेड कारपेट बिछा करके उनका भाजपा में स्वागत किया जा रहा है। अब बताइए वो किस मुंह से ये बात कह रहे हैं जब वो खुद ही जो है कांग्रेस के कई सारे जो हारे हुए नेता हैं उनको ईडी का डर दिखा करके, सीबीआई का डर दिखा करके भाजपा में शामिल करा लिया है।
The Congress party and several INDI block leaders slammed the Bharatiya Janata party for making these statements, calling them baseless, and said the Saffron party will get the answer in the elections when Kanhaiya Kumar fights from this particular constituency and takes on the BJP firebrand leader Manoj Tiwari.
लोकसभा के सांसद होने के नाते उनकी कुछ गरिमा, कुछ मर्यादा के शब्द होने चाहिए, लेकिन बीजेपी में जब आके ही मर्यादा गरिमा नहीं दिखा रहे तो ये लोग कैसे दिखाएंगे। लेकिन मनोज तिवारी के ही लोकसभा के एक कुलीग हैं जो लद्दाख से भाजपा के सांसद हैं, उनकी पत्नी जेएनयू की पढ़ी हुई है। उनका कहना है कि जिस तरह के आरोप कन्हैया कुमार पर दुष्प्रचार किया गया, आरोप लगाए गए, ऐसा उन्होंने कभी कहा ही नहीं था। जो जो नरेंद्र मोदी जी से आंख में आंख डालकर सवाल पूछने की हिम्मत करता है उसको ये कुछ भी कह देंगे। आपके कर्नाटका के नेता संजय पाटिल ने जो अभद्र टिप्पणी हमारी महिला मंत्री के लिए की है, सबसे पहले मोदी जी को कान पकड़ के उसके लिए माफी मांगनी चाहिए।
Times now also hit the ground to get to the pulse of the national capital, the voter in the national capital. What do people think about Kanhaiya Kumar and Manoj Tiwari? Listen in from them.
दिल्ली के नॉर्थ ईस्ट से मनोज तिवारी के सामने कांग्रेस ने कन्हैया कुमार को उम्मीदवार बनाया है। इस वक्त हमारी मौजूदगी नॉर्थ ईस्ट इलाके में है, शादरा में इस वक्त हम मौजूद हैं और यहाँ पे तमाम सारे युवा और तमाम सारे लोग यहाँ पे नजर आ रहे होंगे। उनसे पूछते हैं कि आखिर क्या इस बार मनोज तिवारी के लिए मुश्किलें बढ़ने वाली हैं या फिर कन्हैया कुमार के लिए मुश्किलें बढ़ेंगी, क्योंकि अब आमना सामना होने वाला है मनोज तिवारी वर्सेस कन्हैया कुमार। लोग क्या सोचते हैं, क्या लगता है, मनोज तिवारी ये सांसद रहे हैं, इस बार क्या जनता उनको चुनेगी या फिर कन्हैया कुमार कुमार को किस कैसे उम्मीदवार के तौर पे आप
देखिए? मेरा मानना है जहाँ तक उम्मीद कन्हैया कुमार को ताला गया है कांग्रेस की तरफ से, तो कन्हैया स्टूडेंट के नजरिए से बहुत बेस्ट रहेंगे, क्योंकि उनको नजरिए स्टूडेंट का फीलिंग पता है, बेरोजगारी चरम सीमा पे आ चुकी है।
नहीं, कोई तस्वीर नहीं बदलेगी। ये बीजेपी के मनोज तिवारी जो है यही कुछ करवा सकते हैं। कन्हैया कुमार तो उनका रिकॉर्ड खराब है पहले से ही, टुकड़े टुकड़े गैंग वाले। यहाँ भी अगर बीजेपी की सरकार बनेगी तो विकास होगा।
देखो जी, जीत तो हमारी 100% पक्की है तिवारी जी की। अब हमारा ध्येय जो है उनकी जमानत जब्त करवाने का है। अच्छा। और ऐसे आदमी को जो देश के टुकड़े टुकड़े करना है, उस आदमी को तो वोट देना नरक में वोट देना है। हम चाहेंगे इसकी जमानत जब्त करवाने के लिए।
Okay, you've heard it from the voter in the national capital. Let's hear it from our experts joining us this evening. We have BJP spokesperson Amit Tiwari along with Dr. Nikul Patel, leader of the Congress party. Mr. Patel, my first question is to you. Aapne janta ki awaaz sun li, aapne netaon ki awaaz sun li. Aap kya kahenge? BJP comes out to say that is the Congress out of options to an extent that they're having to field Kanhaiya Kumar, somebody who's made not just anti-forces slogans, anti-India slogans, pro-tukde-tukde slogans.
Congress had filled up a candidate at Delhi and it is against Manoj Tiwari. If we see Kanhaiya Kumar, he is the prominent student leader and we can still remember the speech he spoke when he was out of jail after I think some 9 months into it. And we have seen how what robes have been put on it, but after that he came out and he given a speech. Still it's a memorable speech and he's good leader. I think he can become good representative of the people over
sir,
there.
Sir, memorable to Bharat tere tukde honge wali speech bhi hai, sir. That's also a very memorable speech and that's what the BJP is objecting to today. Why field a controversial candidate, they ask?
I think you must also try to see the half-filled glass. Always, I have seen that the media always want to try out the half-empty glass of Congress and then they try to push it into it and then they stick to the BJP words.
No,
BJP
I'm just directing the BJP's question to you. And I'll go across to Mr. Tiwari as well. He can perhaps question you as well.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
it's just the BJP's criticism that I'm directing to you.
So that is what I'm answering now, that BJP is criticizing it. That is their job. And it is their responsibility also. But our job is to show that Kanhaiya Kumar, if he is becoming a good leader at JNU and he can lead the students and he can become a good representative, I think the Constitution of India allows any person to contest for the Lok Sabha election if he is a citizen of our country and there is
okay.
No probes against
it's
him.
It's the Congress's so prerogative. Mr. Amit Tiwari, why is the BJP intervening unnecessarily? It's just a mudda for the BJP and they're unnecessarily raking it.
No. It's obviously the inner matter of the Congress party and we have nobody to comment on that. But so far as politics is concerned, we are in public life. Obviously, when somebody will be fielded as a candidate, it's our job as an opposition to make people aware as to who the candidate is, what is his background. Now, nomination of Mr. Kanhaiya Kumar from Northeast Delhi raises several questions and there are four aspects to it. The first is, it really exposed the face of the Congress that it stands with the person who was raising the slogan of Tukde Tukde Gang, who was criticizing and making baseless allegations against the Indian Army, number one. Number two, it's not only the allegation by the BJP, but there has been an investigation of the 2016 incident. Charge sheets were filed in 2019. In 2021, the Court of Competent Jurisdiction has taken cognizance. Yes, there is a prima facie case made out of Sedition 124A, and therefore, he's been summoned. So it's not only the BJP, there are enough material which the court also believes in. Secondly, this is going to be a political suicide both for Congress as well as for Kanhaiya Kumar. Kanhaiya Kumar, who originally hails from a Communist Party background and that ideology, contested 2019 election from Begusarai, which is historically believed to be the heartland of the Communist
Party. Sorry to intervene, but Mr. Tiwari, do you also think there is more to do with his Purvanchali background? You know, pitching Manoj Tiwari and Kanhaiya Kumar in Northeast Delhi, do you think that could just be a calculated move? Perhaps a risk Congress is willing to take. All right, he may have chanted those slogans in the past, but that's a risk we're willing to take, given that this is going to be a tough fight.
They might be calculating this, that there are many Purvanchalis, so let us get somebody from Purvanchalis. Therefore, we will have some kind of say or we will have some kind of likelihood of winning the election, but that's not the case. Purvanchali people are very sensitive. They are very matured. They know with whom to stand with. And so far as Mr. Manoj Tiwari is concerned, let me tell you, in last 10 years, projects worth more than 14,600 crores, including various infrastructure projects, have been launched in his constituency. People are aware of it. Let me tell you one thing more. Miss Sheila Dixit contested the election on the last occasion from Congress, from Northeast Delhi. Sheila Dixit was a prominent leader of three times chief minister. Even she could not get a Kendriya Vidyalaya, and in the center also from
Pusat. Okay, let me then direct that to Dr. Nikhil Patel. Dr. Nikhil Patel, is it a risk worth taking? Somebody who's faced sedition charges in the past for the JNU stir, fielding them against a person who's won from the same particular constituency twice already and has been fielded the third time, the only BJP leader to have been fielded again, an incumbent to be fielded again.
ADR report says that more than around 50% member of parliament are facing consequences and cases against them. That doesn't mean they are not contesting elections, and that too from sitting MPs right now, and they are majority of Bharatiya Janata Party. Would they are not eligible for fighting the contesting the elections? I think I would like to ask my friend who is sitting next to me. Second thing, a representative of People's Act is rightly speaking about a person must be eligible and having the potential to put their voice into the floor of parliament. And I think Mr. Kanhaiya Kumar had rightly done in his entire career to put the voice of the student, and now being the National Student Union.
While many parliamentarians may have faced certain charges against them, criminal charges against them, sedition charges, I'm afraid not so many of them have faced in the past. And the BJP is only asking one question. Does this not expose Congress's anti-India mindset? Perhaps an ammunition that the Congress could have avoided giving to the BJP today, given how crucial this election is. That's my only question. Dr. Patel, many thanks for joining us this evening. Thanking Amit Tiwari as well. We head into a very quick break for now. Lots more lined up on the other side. We'll be right back.
Kane, sir, your dinner.
On a tile? And it's antibacterial.
Mm-hmm.
Scratch resistant also.
But plates?
Kane, bye. It's a tile ad.
IM Plus technology se bane world class tiles. Tile ho to simple ho.